Hey folks, we are back again. It's your boy Kunle Alagan. So headlines for you. British institutions return some artifacts to Nigeria. We will give you more detail on that. Also, insecurity continues to dominate the headlines in Nigeria. And also in Africa, there has been a coup in Sudan. And we will give you an update on the Kenyan nurses that were due to work in the UK. Lastly, we will give you an update on the money transfer update. So let's get straight into it. So we understand that Cambridge University has returned some artifacts that the British stole from Nigeria over 100 years ago. Watch some of those in this video.
His Royal Majesty, the Oba of Benin.
So I ask Alexa when I wake up in the morning and I'll get an update on the news and also the weather as well. This is what Alexa has got to say about this. Listen to Alexa here.
Here's what I found from Reuters. A Cambridge University college will on Wednesday hand over to Nigeria a sculpture that was looted by British troops in 1897, setting a precedent that will put pressure on other institutions to return stolen artifacts. The sculpture of a cockerel was one of hundreds of Benin bronzes that were pillaged from the once mighty kingdom of Benin, located in what is now Nigeria. They are among Africa's most culturally significant artifacts, and Nigerian authorities have been calling for years for their return.
Thanks, Alexa.
So this has now been, returned to Nigeria, and clearly a number of these institutions are now forced to start returning all these stolen artifacts to Nigeria, dated back to over 100 years ago. France has also followed suit as well to return some of the artifacts to Nigeria. Hopefully, Nigerian government will see the importance of these artifacts. They will create a kind of, opportunity here where we have a lot of tourists visiting Nigeria to view most of these artifacts. These are the things that have been useful in the Europe. We understand that the British Museum has all of the majority of these artifacts as well. And people are paying fortune to come and watch it in the UK. So clearly, Nigerian government need to seize opportunity in the God-given natural resources that we are endowed with. Create a kind of museum. Let people start coming into the country to come and visit all of these artifacts, take pictures, and there's so much money that can be made out of tourism in a year if well, designated, if well planned in a country. We know what is happening now in Dubai. Tourists amount for over 50% of the GDP of that country now. Why not in Africa? Why not in Nigeria? Hopefully, this opportunity will be taken and will be put into a good use. So still in Nigeria, we understand there's been so many insecurity that continue to dominate headlines in Nigeria. We all know the issue of Fulani herdsmen, Boko Haram, kidnappings. At the moment, Nigeria is also experiencing, economic depression, challenges in Nigeria. And talk about challenges in Nigeria in terms of economy. We have a video of a young Nigerian, Aliyu. He put himself out for sale. Watch him in this video.
Confirming the latest development on Wednesday, the Commander General of the Board, Sheikh Harun Ibn Sina, said that the young man was arrested because it is forbidden in Islam to sell oneself.
So clearly, he put himself out for sale for 20 million naira. And another shocking thing about this video that has gone viral is that this gentleman has actually planned the way he will use this 20 million naira. He said 10 million of that will go to his parents, 5 million will be put into tax use, and 2 million will be given to anyone that helped him to get a buyer, and they will keep the 3 million remaining for himself, and they will make sure that he served the new owner of himself diligently. But understandably, this is not good enough. We understand that he's now been arrested by the Kano government now. Hopefully he will be released, but clearly this is not good. And this is as a result of the challenges that a number of Nigerians are facing in the country. And talk about challenges Nigerians are facing in the country. We have another sad story for you about this gentle lady, Azima Babalola. Meet Azima Babalola. Look at her here. She is doing really well in her studies. She's, you know, in good state of mind, looking beautiful. She's 11 years old lady, living in Lagos State. She's one of four children in the hands of the parents. And at the moment, this lady, you can see the video now that is coming up. She is suffering from a serious illness, a life-threatening illness. So we understand that she's suffering from typhoid, anemia, and liver leakage. This is really sad. She has been taken to the hospital by the parents, and she was referred to the general hospital. Clearly, the general hospital has told the parents that the next time they can see a doctor there is next year, 2022. Look at the picture of the video of this young lady. Do you think she can last for 2022 till 2022? So this is really sad. So what we have done is we have decided to step into the situation. We have spoken to the parents of this lady. We have been able to be of assistance to them. So Kunle Ologun Foundation has sent a number of people in Lagos to go and visit this family. So the first thing we did was to give them a cash of 50,000 naira. You can see that presentation there. So one thing that shocked me was the lady that went to drop this money, by the time she tried to drop it and she came out to call me, and she said to me that she's not sure if this will be used for the treatment of this young girl, that the parents, they've not eaten, they are hungry. And this is so sad. And I said to her, just give it to them. Even if it is that they will eat, they should eat with that money. It's fine. And we will sort something else out for, you know, that child as well. So that child has now been taken to Lute. Now, she's been referred to Lute, and she has been taken there. But a lot of tests are currently being run on this young lady. We understand that there's so much money that is required. So that is why we have brought this to your view. This is the first time that we are doing this on K90 channel, and we cannot see this kind of video and just ignore. This is disturbing. This is sad. This is not, you know, something that anyone will wish for their children. Look at that child. She's so lean and skinny. Clearly, she is not healthy. She is suffering from something that needs to be diagnosed as soon as possible, and she can start treatment. So we are soliciting for your help. We have the bank detail of the mom. That can be flashed. You can see that on the screen now. So the bank detail of the mom is on there. Any amount of money that you think can be of help, no amount is too small. Please drop it in that bank account. It's a GTB bank in Nigeria. Nigerians globally should please come to the aid of Azima Babalola. We plead that you should please, whatever thing you can use to help. And also, when you send this money, please put reference as KOF, which is Kunle Ologun Foundation. And you can then put hyphen and then put your name. You can put your name in front of that. If you don't want to put your name, put Kunle Ologun Foundation, which is just KOF, and then put that hyphen and then put anonymous. We will understand that you do not want to be disclosed. That's fine. But what we will try to do on this show is we will continue to update you on the progress of this little girl. We will update you on the total amount of money that's been, you know, generated, and also we will update you on the treatment and how much has been spent. And hopefully, by God's grace, we pray that she will get better, back to her feet, and she'll be able to get back to school, and she'll be able to come and speak to every one of you. We will bring her to this program and see how we can make help her to speak to every one of you to say thank you to you. We pray that she will get well soon. The parents has been praying for every one of us as well. They're thanking us for the help that we've, you know, supported them with so far. And we hope that more of this assistance will continue to come from all our viewers globally. So thank you so much. Please share this video with all your loved ones, every Nigerian globally. Share it with everyone so that they can come to the aid of Babalola so that we can help her and she can recover from this illness. Also, if you know of any good private hospital in Nigeria that we can take her in Lagos or any part of Nigeria, it's fine. Please suggest it in the comment section below. Also, if you know of any great doctor that can be of assistance as well, please suggest that doctor's name or give us their contact detail and we will get in touch with them. We need help from all asundry. We need help from every source, everywhere, globally, on this lady, on this young girl, so that she will recover from this illness that is plaguing her and her family at the moment. We wish her the very best, and thank you so much for your support as we look forward to those coming through. We will continue to give you updates on the progress. So moving on to Sudan, just last Monday, there's been a coup in Sudan. The current Prime Minister, Abdullah Hamdok, has been arrested by the top military general in the country. So he's saying that there could have been war in the country if that coup had not taken place. But clearly this coup has been condemned by the United Nations Secretary General and the world in general. So clearly this is not good at all. The people of Sudan are currently protesting on the street that the power needs to be returned to the civilian rule. And hopefully this will be resolved in, you know, Sudan. Oh my God, that's so funny. Just be careful, don't do that at home. So moving on to Kenya. So remember sometime in July, we did reported that the Kenyan government and the British government, they strike an agreement that the Kenyan nurses that are unemployed can now come to the UK to work. So part of that requirement to get into the UK for those unemployed Kenyan nurses is that they have to complete English test. We understand that out of 300 Kenyan nurses that took part in this English test, just 10% of them passed. This is really shocking. Remember, the official language in Kenya is English and Swahili, but maybe Swahili is the first language, maybe English is the second language, but clearly they have struggled to pass this English test. And the British government are saying that the NHS in England needs more medical personnel. Due to COVID, they are running short of medical personnel. A number of them have also returned to Europe as a result of Brexit. But now should have been the time that the Kenyan government will seize this opportunity to bring those unemployed nurses into the country. But unfortunately, majority of them have not been able to pass that test. Hopefully this will be resolved in the country. So moving on to other news in Africa. So those are the other news that are trending in Africa. Moving on to money transfer update for this week. So as you can see on this slide, Aboki FX is still not currently reporting anything. According to the CBN of Nigeria, Central Bank of Nigeria, they are still shut down at the moment, which is the standard FX rate that we use to benchmark all of the money transfer companies. Also, those items that are still in yellow, they are yet to revert back to transacting in Naira to Nigeria. So clearly, we're still not monitoring those. They've not reverted to transacting to Nigerian Naira. But for those two that are on top, we can see transfer for this week, we can see their rate. So for this week, transfer pounds to Naira is 733 Naira to 1 pound. In terms of the second one, which is transfer wise, we have their pound is currently 533 Naira to 1 pound, their euro is 449 Naira to 1 euro, and their dollar is 388 Naira to 1 dollar. So as we have always said, we bring you this money transfer update to all our viewers so that you can take a decision on which of these money transfer companies to use when you send money to your loved ones across the world. Hopefully this video has helped someone for this week. Please feel free to share it with your loved ones. If you are yet to subscribe to K90 channel on YouTube, please kindly do so. Also, please don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Thank you so much for watching this video, and bye for now.